रावण छुड़ करके अकुल के साथ अर्थात अकुल के रथ में बैठ करके वृंदावन के परिसीमा को पार कर फिर मथुरा में प्रवेश किया और मथुरा आदि जो है दर्शन कर मथुरापुर के अच्छी तरह से दर्शन किया।
Now went to Mathura, so first he has visited all Mathura very nicely, and then after that he entered into the Ranga Lesha, the fight place of. Am I audible to you? Please check. Hare Krishna. Am I audible to you? So when Krishna was visiting the Mathura, so seeing the beautiful form of Krishna, all the Ramaniya, all the ladies of the Mathura. So they were ashaming herself, they were teasing herself that what they were saying. So they were reciting the shloka of Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam, 10 canto 44 chapter in the 14th shloka. One lady to another gopi is saying that we don't know what kind of austerity did gopi did, that by the eyes they are relishing the beautiful form of Krishna. What kind of form he has? It is just like a Lavanya Sar. So no form is equal to Krishna's form. What to speak about others? So one cannot get this kinds of form after decorating or makeup herself, himself. So Krishna's beautiful form is Swayam Siddha. So seeing that beautiful form, because every day is a very youthfulness and looking very beautiful. So no one can take the darshan other than the gopis. So that's why gopis are so much fortunate. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur in the Bangla Kirtan, so text was spoken by young beautiful woman of Mathura in Krishna's wrestling arena when they had received darshan of Sri Krishna's. So why, which kind of austerities the gopis of the Vrindavan, they are taking the darshan of Krishna's beautiful form and they are relishing the shamras every day, every time.
Everything is okay. Channel comment up.
So now we are going to hear further.
लावण्य का दर्शन कर, विष्णु कर एवं उसके असाधारण में लड़ाई कर,
So the Mathura's Ramanas are saying, Hi Sakhi, what kind of austerity did the done by the gopis of Vrindavan that by there they always relish the beautiful form of Krishna? So what kind of extraordinary beauty of Shri Krishna's form? They have made their birth, body and mind successful. What is this beauty like? There is no Roop Madhurya equal to or greater than this. In Paravyom there are so many forms of Bhagwan. But even Narayan, Shri Krishna's pastime expansion is not equal to Krishna. So the darshan which is taking by the Mathura's Raminiya, so what kind of beautiful form is that? That all the ladies of Mathura, they never took the darshan of Nandanandan Krishna. But they have heard about little bit of Brijendanandan Krishna. So the ladies who are selling the fruits, when they used to go to Vrindavan, because Mathura is just a town, so it is a business land, prominent land of business, where are many kinds of big businessmen used to live here in Mathura. And Vrindavan, who used to live? So the Gwalwal, the cowherds by Gopi, they were used to live there. The peoples who are cow herding, they used to live in Vrindavan. That's why. So some ladies of Mathura who were selling the fruits, they used to go to Vrindavan for selling their fruits. So we have already heard a lady who was selling the fruits. So their katha is mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So all those fruit seller ladies, when they used to go to Vrindavan, so in the Vrindavan, by the gopi's mouth, they used to hear the glories of, they used to hear the glory of Krishna. And after hearing the glories of Krishna, when they return back to Mathura, so they used to all the things they discuss about the ladies of Mathura, about the Madhurita, Sondarita of Krishna. But they never took the darshan of Krishna. That what kind of beautiful Vrindavan Krishna form is. But at first time today, so they got the fortune to take the darshan of Krishna of Mathuradish. But who is that Krishna? He is Mathuradish Krishna. He is not. So in their fortune they never got the darshan of Brijendanandan Shyam Sundar. But still when they are taking the darshan of Mathuradish Krishna, so they are causing or they are teasing their fortune. Then what kind of austerity that village gopis did? That gopis, the Vrindavan gopis, what kind of austerities they have done? That by the consequence of that, so they are always relishing the Roop Madhurya of beautiful form of Krishna. So their life is successful. So they have made their life successful. Because what kind of that beautifulness was it? Vrindavan Krishna. When Krishna was living in Vrindavan, so the Madhurama or Sondarya of Krishna, it is when they are seeing the beautifulness of Mathuradish Krishna, so what to speak about the Vrindavan Krishna? Why they are saying like this?
ये समस्त मथुरा मुनि आदि
So whenever all the Mathura's ladies, when they heard the glories and the Sondara Madhurma of Vrindavan Krishna by the ladies who are selling the fruits in Vrindavan, so now when they are comparing, so they are teasing their fortune that what kind of austerity done by the gopis. So the Tikakar is saying here, So Nandanandan Krishna is a Swayam Swarup, Swayam Roop. So Krishna always resided in Braj Vrindavan in Swayam Roop. Swayam Prakash. Okay, so after Swayam Roop there is another form, that is Swayam Prakash. Then Taditatmak, Avesh, or many kinds of actions, expansion are like this, according to Tattva Vichar. But in Vaikunth, so in the Vaikunth, Krishna Vilas Murti Narayan, their beautifulness is not less, but we cannot compare that Narayan form with Brajendandan Krishna. Because according to the Krishna Dham and Parikar, Prakash Karta, Krishna always express his bhav and form according to the bhav of devotee. Krishna is one, Paratattva Bhagwan. But by his Achinta Shakti, so he expresses form according to the feelings of the devotee. How he expresses Swarup? According to their Dham and Parikar. Just kinds of their Parikar, just like their Parikar or Dham. So according to their Parikar or Dham, he expresses form. He expresses his feeling. In the Vaikunth, Vishaksen and the Garun, they are eternal associates of Krishna. So they are the Shanta Pradhan Dasa, Shanta prominent in the Vaikunth. In the Vaikunth, there is Shantaras is prominent and Dasa is secondary. So that's why the same Vrijendandan Krishna in the Vaikunth, he resides in the form of Narayan. So this Narayan for beautiful form is not less than other, but is still. So seeing the beautifulness of Narayan, everybody attracted. But if we talk about the Nandanandan Krishna, there is speciality Char Madhurma like, which is called the unique and unparalleled. Nothing, no one and nothing is equal than that. This is unparalleled and unequal. So who has this kinds of four qualities like Rupa Madhurya, Prema Madhurya, Venu Madhurya or Leela Madhurya. So these kinds of four Madhurya, by this four Madhurya, Krishna is attracted three worlds, three Jagat. He attracted all the worlds. Three Jagat. What if we are talking about three Jagat? The three Jagat, what is that? Chit Jagat, Jeev Jagat, and Maya Jagat. From Vaikunth to Golok Vrindavan. So from Vaikunth to Golok Vrindavan, he is attracting everybody. That is called Chit Jagat. Even Dwarka, Mathura and Vrindavan. So who are Jeev, are living entities staying there. So Krishna is attracting everybody. So he has this kinds of beautiful form. Why Krishna has, expressed his beautifulness in the topmost form in Vrindavan? Because the associates of Vrindavan, So the Sondare Madhure of that Parikar, according to that Parikar Sondare Madhure, just like the beautifulness of Sondare Madhure of Radharani is not less than Krishna anyhow, but still it is higher than Krishna. Even somewhere it is told that higher than Krishna, just like the glorification, the beautifulness of Radharani, Lavanya. So it can defeat the Sondarya Madhurya of Krishna. That's why Krishna is attracted towards her, Radharani. Krishna is saying himself. Seeing the Sondarya Madhurya of Radharani, I attracted myself. Krishna is saying, by the fragrance of my body, every world is fragranted. But by the body's fragrance of Radharani, I am attracted towards her. So the fragrance of Radharani's body is which can intoxicate Krishna. That's why Radharani and Madhav Gandh Madita. Madita. Madhav Gandh Madita. This is Radharani's another name. Madhav Gandh Madita. So the topmost, that's why the topmost name of Srimati Radhakarani, Madhavi, who has the Madhita intoxication. So the body fragrance and the intoxication of her body is defeated the Krishna's Madhurya. That's why she is called Madhavi. That's why Raghunath Das Goswami Istabhavali, he is describing Madhav Gandh Madhita. So Madhavi, by his body's fragrance, she is intoxicated Krishna. Krishna is saying himself like this. How beautiful the Rupa Madhurya is Krishna, Radharani have. That's why Sanatan Goswami Path in Brad Bhagavatam he is describing, according to the Bhakt and Dham, the Advaita Gyan Paratattva Bhagavan Shri Krishna, he expresses himself in that form. So it is not depending of the Katha is a speaker, speaking by the speaker. Vakta knows everything. The person who is speaking, that is called Vakta. That is called a speaker. Who always speak, he is called the speakers. He knows everything. Some people used to say that he is speaking too much, because his name is speaker, that's why he is speaking too much. He knows everything. So the speaker's katha is depend on the listeners. What kind of listeners are there? Sukhdev Goswami Pad, what katha he told to Parikshit Maharaj for 7 days, 7 nights continuously, how he did like this? Because this Parikshit Maharaj has this kind of symptoms, but all other Shrotas was, they are nothing. He was targeting only Parikshit Maharaj. Somebody is listening, somebody are not listening. So, there are one is Sarota, one is Shrota, and one is Sota. Eager. So Parikshit Maharaj was listening the Harikatha with too much eagerness. So in the Bhagavad there is also Katha is there. Sukhdev Goswami Pad, when he was describing the Krishna Katha, so he got observed in the Bhav. His throat was choked, the tears was coming out from the eyes. So for some time he stunned there. So seeing that Parikshit Maharaj used to say, Hey Prabhu, Hey Brahman, the time is wasting. My time is passing away. Because after seven days, on the eighth day, Takshak snake will come and bite me. So what the activity I have did? So how can I be free from that? I got the punishment of that. Okay, so I wanted to serve the Sant Mahatma, but still I got the service of I give the service to Sant Mahatma. I wanted to serve him, but I was served him. What is the duty of the Raja? That he has to serve the Sant Mahatma, saintly person. But I got this kinds of ego that I am the king. And Vringi? Shamik Rishi. So I asked for the water from Shamik Rishi. Shamik Rishi, I wanted to get rid of my thirst. Are we should serve the Sant Mahatma. We should serve the saintly person. But just because I was 30, I ordered and I asked for the water of the Sant Mahatma. When he didn't give me the water, so I punished him. What is the reason? I had the thirst. So that thirst I was like to get rid of by your Harikatha. So by hearing the Harikatha from your lotus mouth, I would like to get rid of my thirst. I don't want to waste my time even a single moment. So whatever the Harikatha you are saying, I would like to get the nectar of that. I would like to get that nectar again and again, again and again. So what's my mean to say? So whatever the Harikatha Sukhdev Goswami Pad said, who was the prominent listener? Parikshit Maharaj. Because he had so much eagerness in his mind and body that he was listening Harikatha very attentively. So that's why he is called Shrota. That's why he is called the Shrota, the listeners who had deep kinds of eagerness in their hearts for listening Harikatha. So being this kinds of eagerness, eager, if we hear Harikatha, then a speaker will speak on. If the speaker is seeing that all the listeners are sleeping, so waking up Jai Jai Shri Radhe. So if the listeners are sleeping, so he will say, oh, you have come, yes, it, and you have gone. So because he has to flee away the sleeping. If it is mentioned in the scriptures, when in the Bhagavad Katha, if listeners are listening, so they got the body of a snake in their next birth. So that's why it is like, wake up soul, wake up. That's why seeing those listeners who are sleeping, seeing that the speaker used to do a little bit joke so that they can wake up and listen Harikatha. One is the listener Shrota, one is sleeper Sota, and third is Srota. There is a kinds of astra which is used for cutting the supari. So that person never listen and he disturb to all who is listening Harikatha. He take the beats back and chant the holy name, but he is not chanting the actually name. When he started, he is pretending to chant the holy name. He don't chant the holy name. He just take the beats back in his hand. So the people who are listening Harikatha here and there, so always try to disturb them. And 3 hours he neither chant nor listen Harikatha. So that's why in the Brihad Bhagavatam, Sri Sanatana Goswami Pad is saying, Sri Bhagwan, so whatever the Sundarya Madhurya Bhagwan expresses according to the Dham and the Parikar. What kind of Parikar? और इफ दे आर ऐश्वर्ययुत परिकर
धाम परिकर के साथ एक ही
बिकॉज ही हैज द सेम फीलिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द धाम एंड परिकर. So there is a special character of Mathura's Ramanis, how they got this kinds of feeling in their hearts for Govind darshan and the glorification of Govind, because the sailor, the ladies who used to sail the fruits in Vrindavan, so by their mouth they have heard the glories and the Saundarya Madhurya of Krishna. That's why they are attracted toward Vijayanandan Shyam Sundar. That's why in their heart this kinds of shameful feelings coming. They are shaming herself, fie on my life. Why they are saying? Because the darshan we are taking at the moment of Krishna, he has so much beautiful form. But when Krishna resides in Vrindavan and that Gopiya was taking a darshan, that was different. So the katha we have heard from the fruit sailor, the ladies who was selling the fruits, so they told the glory of the Krishna of Saundarya Madhurya of Krishna, so that was different from the Mathuradhis Krishna. So Radha, Lita and other Sakhis and other Gopis and the Chandravali and Manjari, Rupa Manjari, so they have taken the different kinds of darshan of Krishna. That's why it is in Gopastapa. What kind of austerity Gopis did? So they have taken this kinds of darshan. So here one thing is mentioned that gopis, so no one can take the darshan of Krishna by austerity. Gopiya didn't take the darshan of by austerity of Krishna, because this is Swayam Siddha. So Shri Krishna's Aladini Shakti Swarupani, Srimati Radhakarani and all the Sakhis and all the Gopis are the expansion of Srimati Radhakarani. They are Kaya view. So they didn't take the darshan of Krishna by any austerities. It is not possible. But all these ladies of Mathuras are saying that what kind of austerity that these gopis did. So what kind of form he has? Lavanya Sar. Lavanya, who is? Lavanya means there are kinds of mukta phal. So there are kinds of fruit which is called mukta fruit. So inside there is kinds of aura is coming. That is called Lavanya. When just like so the aura, the light, the effulgence in the body of that fourth Sanat Kumar, when they went to Dwarka, went to Vaikunth, so seeing that the Jayavijaya was astonished. In the same way, if somebody is following the Brahmacharya, so he will get this kinds of aura in his body. So this kinds of aura is called Lavanya. So this kinds of effulgence was coming out from the body of Krishna. So Krishna's beauty is topmost. It is incomparable, perfect and natural, and it is not brought about by any kind of ornamentation. So which is the origin of Saundarya Madhurya? It is coming from Krishna, Nandanandan Krishna, Brajendanandan Krishna. So Shri Krishna's, which is filled with unequaled beauty, is only present in Vrindavan, and Brajbhumi is blessed because the original person, Puran Purush, performs pastimes there in this disguise. That Puran Purush Krishna, where he stays, that Brajbhumi, that Braj devis of that Braj are so much fortunate that they are taking a darshan of Dhir Lalit Nayak Krishna. Look, by these things it is appeared that the gopis of the Vrindavan, they are not illiterate, they are very scholar ladies, because it is saying here, because it is saying this Braj Devis are so much fortunate, especially blessed, because they receive darshan of Dhir Lalit Nayak Shri Krishna, who is adorned with all beauty and sweetness. Hero. So Krishna is denoting here as the Dhir Lalit Nayak. He is the topmost hero. Krishna, in the Tattva Vichar, Krishna is so beautiful. तीन सौ छियानवे नायिका 360 और 96 काइंड्स ऑफ नायक. देर आर 96 काइंड्स ऑफ नायक हीरो एंड 360 काइंड्स ऑफ नायिका हीरोइंस. सो इट इज ऑल एक्सप्रेस इन द नायिका प्रकरण. व्हेन द टाइम विल कम आई विल लेट यू नो अबाउट दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू टाइम. सो देर आर 96 काइंड्स ऑफ नायक. हु इज द टॉप मोस्ट? दीर ललित नायक. So Dhir Lalit Nayak is called the topmost Nayak, topmost hero. And who is that? So who has all kinds of qualities of Dhir Lalit Nayak? He has Krishna only. Krishna has all kinds of qualities of Dhir Lalit Nayak. So that's why four kinds of qualities Dhir Lalit Nayak have. He is situated in Krishna's. It is completely state situated in Krishna. Navinovincha, Nishindita, Parihaspatu or Bab. Vasibhut, Priyashri Vasibhuta. So this is the topmost four qualities is situated in Krishna. So it is situated in Gopijan Vallabh and Radhakant. Gopish Gopikakant, Radhakant Namastate. There is a Prajana. Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu. दीन बंधु जगत भक्ति गोपीश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत. यह गोपिका कांत मीन्स ऑल द चंद्रावली अदर गोपीज एंड सर्वोपरि सर्वोपरि इन द टॉप मोस्ट इज राधा कांत. गोपिका कांत मीन्स ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ गोपीज एंड राधा कांत मीन्स राधा कांत. So Krishna has presented his topmost form in the Ras Leela before Radha ji. Sambarta Pratna with Kansa? Gandharva. So Gandharva Pratna ka Ashtakam. Everything is described there. The beautifulness or the Sondarya Madhurya of Radhika Rani. Not only one. And if we assemble all the beauties of different lokas of Lakshmi, but it is not comparable by the toes nails of Srimati Radhika Rani. That's why Anand Koti Vishnu Loka. So the opulence or the aura of the her toes nails is defeating the beautifulness of Anant Koti Vishnu Lok's Lakshmi. So what to speak about the glories and the Sondarya of Srimati Radhika Rani. So that's why it is saying the Braj Devis, they are so fortunate of Braj, because they are taking the darshan of Dhir Lalit Nayak every day, every time. Amusya Rupa. By the word Amusya, the woman of Mathura knows. Amusya means that they are indicating by our insignificant piti, by our insignificant piti, we are receiving Shri Krishna's darshan. but the gopis' pity is complete. So the Mathura's Ramanis are saying, we don't have the fortune to take the darshan of Vrijendran Shyamsundar Krishna, but our little bit fortune that we are taking the darshan of Mathura this Krishna. But the gopi's pity is full, complete. Oh, omniscient munis, please direct us how to perform austerities like those performed by the gopis, so that we also will be able to gaze at Shri Krishna's sweet form in Braj. Uddhava is praying like this, Mathura ki Ramaniya. So Uddhava did the same prayers, and the Mathura's Ramanis, the ladies of Mathura, are so doing same kinds of prayers. What kind of prayer we do so that we can take the darshan of Vrijendran Shyamsundar? It is not possible by the austerities actually. What is the principle of Siddhant here? It is not possible by the austerities. You cannot take the darshan of Vrijendran Krishna. But still, all the Mathura's Ramanis, ladies of Mathura, they are saying that what kind of austerity we do so that we can take the darshan of Vrijendran Krishna. So another woman Mathura said, amazement, O Sakhi, austerity, O Sakhi, the good fortune of the Braj Gopis is not result of any austerities. Their prem is without cause and cannot be expressed in words. If she had said, we can also go to Vraj and drink the nectar of Krishna's beauty like the gopis, another lady would have replied, that is very difficult for us. Durapan. This is very difficult for us. Very difficult. Durapan means atyant durlabh, very very difficult, very very rare. So if we go to Braj and take the darshan of like gopis of Krishna, no, it is very rare to us. Durapan. So only by the mercy of gopis who possess the topmost prem is it is possible to drink this nectar. So if we get the mercy of that gopis who are the parampremi, who are the topmost lover of Krishna, so if we get the mercy of them, how we can get the mercy of them? So we have to take the birth in the Vraj, not in Mathura. We have to take the birth in Vraj. Until we won't take the birth in Vraj, in the gopi womb, so it's not possible that we can take the darshan of Vrijendran Krishna. So Bhakti Vinod Thakur, the Kamal Manjari, is very humbly saying, he's saying like this, very humbly, we have to give up this body. It is not possible by this body. So after leaving the Braj mein, so we have to take the birth in the Vishvanupuri, where Radha Rani has got the birth. Vishvanupuri janam laiva. Where the Radha Rani's pastimes, so we have to take birth there. At the land of Radharani pastime. Janm lena padega. So you have to take the birth in the Vrindavan, in the Vrishikhanukule, like where the pastime did by Radharani. And you have to take the birth in the gopi womb, and you have to get the gopi form. संग करना पड़ेगा. सो देन यू हैव टू एसोसिएट द नित्य सिद्ध इटर्नल एसोसिएट्स ऑफ कृष्णा दैट नित्य गोपीज. इफ यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द एसोसिएशन ऑफ नित्य सिद्ध गोपीज नॉट ओनली वन डे एवरी डे अनावृति मीन्स अगेन एंड अगेन यू हैव टू टेक द एसोसिएशन ऑफ और शेल्टर ऑफ द नित्य सिद्ध गोपीज. Because by their association you will get the bhav, but if there is no maturity in your bhav, until your feelings, your bhav is not matured, so till then you have to take the shelter and associate with Nitya Siddha Gopis. And if somebody says that if your feelings is mature, your bhav is mature, then there is no need to take the shelter and association of gopi, nitya siddha gopis. No, you have to take the shelter or associate with that gopis too. That's why. So the Sakhi saying, oh Sakhi, please go to chalo, we are going to Vraj. We can also go to Vraj and drink the nectar of Krishna's beauty like the gopis. Another lady would have replied, that is very difficult for us, Durupayan. So it is only possible by the mercy of the gopis who are observed in the prema, topmost love. So how we will get this kinds of mercy? Until we won't get the dust of mahat people, the sant person, we cannot get that love. Why Krishna is falling? Why Krishna is falling and chasing the gopis? Because they would like to get the dust of gopis' feet. Krishna himself, while taking the dust of Vraj gopis, they are chasing, they are always running behind the gopis. Why they are chasing and why they are running behind to the gopis? So that they can take the dust of gopis' feet. Krishna is also so much eager. What kind of miracle in the dust of the gopis? They just want to know that. When Krishna was staying in Dwarka, so he was remembering that. That's why Krishna himself, he made a leela that I am suffering. This is called the sickness leela. He said this fever will be gone when I will get the dust of my devotee, topmost devotee. So it is not possible by the Rukmanis and other Maheshni, because even they didn't give that. Krishna knew that. So the further leela, I am not describing the leela because you know everything what happened there. Krishna knew everything. So Rukmani and Satyamama and other Dwarikas, Mahishniya, my fever will not go or I will not be satisfied. But if I get the dust of Vraj Gopis, that's why Krishna give the inspiration in the Narad Rishi's heart. And then Narada Rishi went to Vraj and he collected all the dust of gopis. And Krishna, what he Krishna did after getting the dust of Vraj gopis' feet, Krishna took a shower on that. That's why in the Srimad Bhagavatam saying Anuvrajya. Why Krishna is chasing and running behind towards gopis? Because they would like to get the Vraj gopis' dust, feet's dust. So what kind of miracle in the dust of gopis' feet? That's why Krishna is chasing and running behind gopis always. How beautiful is that? Dhul mein dusre, fully taking the shower. So where I saw the Seva Kunj. So the essence of the Veda, Krishna, he is rolling on the feet of Radharani in the Seva Kunj. What kind of shlok is that? I used to speak that shloka. So the essence of Vedant, Darshan, anybody knows? So the essence of Vedant, Shri Krishna, he is taking and he is rolling on the grounds of Nandanandan, Krishna, Nandanandan. There is another shloka, the essence of Veda or Krishna. He is rolling on the grounds of Nanda Maharaj courtyard. How is rolling on the grounds of Nanda Maharaj Goshala? If I remember, then I will let you know. Anybody knows, please tell me. So the essence of Krishna, Vedanta, is Krishna. That Krishna in the Goshala and in the cow shade of Nanda Maharaj, he is rolling on the ground there. You check. Upar. So the Nandanandan Krishna is a speciality. When Krishna comes to close Radha Rani, क्या हो जाता है?
अच्छा
So when Krishna comes close to Radharani, he get the Tribhanga form. He became Teda, zigzag. He is not straight before Radharikarani. So with other gopis, he efforts little bit. But when he get the fragrance of the body of Srimati Radharikarani, he get zigzag way in a three-banded form. The women of Mathura glorified the good fortune of Vraj Devis and eagerly desired to have a seva like theirs. So they used to hear from the fruit sellers and others coming from Vraj about the sweet pastime of Shri Krishna and the Braj Devis. So by hearing the descriptions of these pastimes, a yearning for a seva like that of the gopis arose in their hearts. So they got the greed, but it is possible by the greed? No, it's not possible by that. If it is there a common view, so after thousands or after 100 kinds of verse, the Sukriya is collecting. So how it is possible by the getting greed in your heart? No, it's not possible. You can pray only. When we go, one is general view and another is deep view, a special view. If we go into the deep view, so we will come to know it is not possible by the greed only. That's why the Braj Prem is always Kripasa there. It's only possible by the mercy. So without the mercy, it's not possible. The Braj Prem you can get by only the mercy. So that's why Braj Prem is Kripasa there. You can attain the Braj love by the mercies only. Brahma, Shiva and Lakshmi, which is very rare to them, impossible for them. So how we can get that which kind of Braj Prem, that kind of Braj Prem? That's why it is saying, Raghavendra Super Swami is saying,
Mm-hmm.
So this is a shlok. So one pointed unflinching faith in Radharani's feet and staying in the Braj, and associates of Nitya Siddha Gopis, association of Nitya Siddha Gopis, and hearing the glorification and the pastime of Krishna. So these all kathas. And still if they mercy, because their mercy in their hand, it's not our hand. So we can only pray like this. We can only do the prayer only. So that's why it's saying so by the hearing they got this kinds of grief like gopis. So this is all described in the 6th Sashtayam Sadhan. Everything is very beautifully described here, nicely described here. So further Bhakti Vinod Thakur is saying, who is describing the Saptam Yam Sadhan, Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol.